Good morning, everybody. So you are welcome to this media, and you are live with us in the logic and philosophy, and of course, human existence class. This is important class for every human to participate in order to understand how to relate. So in this first video, we'll be talking about introductory materials. We'll be talking about introductions on philosophy. So we'll start with what is philosophy, father of philosophy, pillars of philosophy, importance of philosophy, and branches of philosophy. And of course, your assignment is very important, which you will drop at the comment section. You put your matric number, your name, the matric number, then the answer to the assignments. Then, in addition to this video, I will remind you, or I will give you some exam-related questions so that you will be able to practice with them. So, what is philosophy? Now, philosophy is from the Greek word, and by the way of Latin, philosophia, which means love of wisdom. So don't forget that philosophy has a Greek parlance and a way of Latin word, which is love of Sophia. So it's called philosophia, which is love of wisdom. And when we talk about love of wisdom, as philos implies Sophia also, which is wisdom. So you can see the division, philos. Or philo, then sophia. So philo is a kind of love, while sophia is wisdom. Putting them together, love of wisdom. Moving forward, what is philosophy itself? It is the fundamental nature of knowledge, reality of life, and existence of human, especially when it is considered as academic discipline. It is also a theoretical study of guiding principles for behavior. And it is also the attitudinal explanation of events in human lives. So, the third definition I will give here is the rationale of thinking, the methodology of considering reality of human life and experiences. Okay, another definition that we may bring forward is that philosophy is the systematic study of ideas and issues, reasons, and pursuit of fundamental truths. So when we talk about philosophy, we are actually pursuing fundamental truths. You are reasoning systematically, you are thinking in order to bring out a quest for comprehending human world, human behavior, conduct, and attributes of life. So you can see what philosophy entails in that particular idea. So generally, you can say, Buddhists have their philosophy, Christians have their philosophy, Islam has its philosophy, and many other things in related manner. Let's move closer to what father of philosophy we have. There are fathers of philosophy, but there's a father of philosophy. And of course, the father of philosophy is Socrates of Athens. So don't forget that, Socrates of Athens, father of philosophy. And he lived between 470 to 399 BC. That's before Christ era, 470. Some other scholars will say 469, okay, to 399. But that his death day is sacrosanct, before Christ era. And Socrates is among the most famous figures in world history, and his contribution to development of ancient Greek philosophy. And his contribution to ancient Greek philosophy became the foundation for Western philosophy, and that's why he's known as father of Western philosophy as well. So you can see Socrates' philosophy has two legs. The first leg is on Greek philosophy, which was moved or adapted and integrated into the Western philosophy. And that's why it's referred to as a father of philosophy. Now we know the father of philosophy and some basic things about philosophy. Before those basic things about philosophy, that's the pillars, let me quickly remind us or tell us about some things about how philosophy started. Talking about history or some early things about philosophy, we trace it back to the 6th century, right? 6th century, that's before Christ era, where the pre-Socrates era, when we have people like Thales, Heraclitus, Pyramides, and many more that revolutionized the thinking and world order. So, in this case, we now have people that developed their ideas. People like Aristotle come into the history. People like Pythagoras also come into the history and the like. So those are some embellishments you should know in this particular video. Moving forward, what are the pillars of philosophy? We have four basic pillars of philosophy, but we can divide it into two. One, theoretical philosophy and practical philosophy. The theoretical philosophy include metaphysics and epistemology, while the practical philosophy includes ethics, social and political philosophy, and aesthetics. So you can see those are the major pillars of philosophy. And if we want to break it down from the two into four, we talk about metaphysics, epistemology, ethics, social and political philosophy. The aesthetics can be along with social and political philosophy. So that makes the four pillars. And moving forward, we talk about some important philosophers that their work in the recent development of philosophy cannot be overemphasized, especially in Western philosophy. We talk about Rens Descartes, we talk about Leibniz, we talk about Spinoza, Locke, that's John Locke, we talk about Berkeley, we talk about Hume and Kant. These seven philosophers, they stood out from the rest in the modern philosophy of the world. So a question can come out, related question can come out in the exam, saying that which of the following is not a modern philosopher? Okay, so these seven people, their work stood out, and that's why they are referred to as modern philosophers, and their work are the basics for others. Another exam question that can come forth is what I've asked in the father of philosophy, which is who is the father of philosophy? So you know it already. Yes, Socrates. Socrates of Athens and not Socrates of other places. Moving forward, let's go to the branches of philosophy. Then we'll move to the importance of philosophy. Now, talking about branches of philosophy, philosophy, just like the pillars, it has seven major branches, okay? And these are the branches that are expedient for us in this study. The first is metaphysics. The second is axiology. The third is epistemology. The fourth is logic. The fifth is ethics. The sixth is political philosophy. And the seventh is aesthetics. Okay, so all of these, they are what make and harmonize science and makes human existence to be logical. Okay, so your first assignment is those pillars of philosophy. So in answering those assignments, you know what you do? Your meaning of metaphysics, just go to the comment section. Your meaning of axiology, just one sentence for each. You don't need to write epistle or long LAQ, long answered question. It's just SAQ, short answered question. So talk briefly on these seven branches of philosophy. in one line for each. Metaphysics, aetiology, epistemology, logic, ethics, political philosophy, and aesthetics. So those things put together. So those are the assignments for this particular recording. Now, quickly, let's talk about the importance of philosophy. Why is philosophy so important to us? The first thing is that it enhances persons' problem-solving capacity. So philosophy helps you to understand a problem and helps you to solve such problem. Two, it helps us to analyze concepts. Okay? So you get a concept, you'll be able to analyze it. Two, it helps us to define concepts. Three, it helps us in argument formation. And four, it helps us in problem solving. So, that should be the fifth point there. Then as well, number six, it contributes to our capacity in organizing ideas. Okay, you'll be able to organize ideas. You know the philosophy of life. You know the pattern of your living. You organize yourself. Eight, it deals with questions of value and to extract what is essential quantity or qualities of a particular information. So we'll stop at this particular recording now. So make sure you comment in the comment section. That's where you put your assignments, you put your matric number, you put your name, you put your department, then you answer the question there. Okay, I hope you get that right. So make sure you subscribe, make sure you like, and you share to your fellow scholars that need to understand this particular study. So in the next class, we'll talk about some other important things. Perhaps we'll move to what is logic and some important things about logic. So we are just concluded the first study on the introductions on what philosophy is. If you have any other question, you can drop the question as well underneath the assignments that you have done. All right, thank you, and God bless you all.